I mean, I bought the equipment, plus I repaired it, took it apart, and rebuilt it, and then, you know, so that, I don't even try to figure out my time and energy, because it's like, that's not the point. I'm not writing it off on any taxes or anything. It is nothing but a gesture that is contrary to the sending of money and guns that have gone on for generations.
Now, what we're talking about is having a fiddle-off,
right,
between us and Dublin.
Yes,
where we would actually send. We're going to send them a violin or a fiddle.
Send them a violin as a gesture between the occupied groups.
And then we're going to be live streaming that, correct?
Yes. I was approached a couple weeks ago now by a gentleman who said that he had been in touch with Dublin and that they would like to do a fiddle-off. He didn't state it like fiddle-off, like as if it's a competition, but just a live stream with both our musicians and their musicians on deck, and one song play a song, and the other play a song, something like that. But I also have access to a lot of equipment that I've been collecting over the last few years and repairing, and among that equipment there's several fiddles that I have put together. And so I thought that it would be a nice gesture to send one to the other occupied group as a gift, this is something that we have access to, and I'm not sure like what's going on with the other group, but I'd like to have to open doors and to start an intercommunication between occupied groups. And everybody that I talk to about that agrees with the idea. They all love it, and so we're ready to go forward with the idea. I have the violin all ready to go, and what we're going to do is put it in a box and have an address, fill out the customs report, and it's all good to go. I haven't been keeping track with any of the news through media, whatever. I've been busy with the Occupy here, but we're ready to go whenever.
Well, what do you think about what's going on with the Occupy movement here?
I think that because we haven't been wasting our resources battling ourselves, battling the police, and battling city officials or anything of that nature, which has been going on several other Occupy groups that I've read about, heard about on the media. I think that's to our benefit, not wasting those resources. We work with the police. They support us. The fire department supports us. They're all part of the 99%. And should be held with equal respect, and which I'm firmly a firm believer on. There are incidences of inner squabbling in the group that are very minor. I feel that sometimes that, because there's no major problems at this point with our move, with this particular group, the little things seem to take the news of the day within the group, you know, which is, in my opinion, it's a waste of energy. The inner squabblings, in my opinion, should be, if there are two parties within the group that have irreconcilable differences, both parties should be removed, should remove themselves until those difficulties, until those differences are reconciled, before they bring that back into the group, because there's two sides to everything, and what we have to do is much more important than the nature of any inner bickering, in my personal opinion. Those things can be worked out.
Oh, absolutely.
They're just mostly personality conflicts and things of that nature. When you set yourself up against the hardships of preparing for the winter and the weather and everything, it's kind of, people get a little bit agitated by the by it being uncomfortable. That's what we're here for. We're going to show them our mettle. We're going to show them how our stamina stay here throughout the winter, through the elements, prepare ourselves for it, and continue our fight, dealing with the task at hand, and try to keep our spirits up at the same time.
Sure, it's going to be a little difficult once we get about 2 feet of snow on the ground.
But this is a football town, and snow football is snow football is the best football.
Now I'm looking around our media tent here, and I see a bunch of these photographs lining. Now you took these pictures, right?
Correct.
And you're a photographer.
It was one of my skills. I have a variety of disciplines, a variety of areas of interest, and among them is photography. And being part of this group from the first march or whatever, I've been privy to all the inside little details of the workings of the group, and have kept a documentary. I don't have like any special equipment I'm using. I just have a little tiny Canon ELF camera, which has survived so far, and a little flip video, so I can do little MP4s, video of various actions or group activities or whatever. And I've been attempting to put all that online best I can. I don't really have access to a computer while I'm down here, other than the media people have various equipment that they use, and so I kind of wait in line to put my stuff onto their computers, and then if there's time, they can put that online. There's a lot of music. I brought in a selection of my equipment that I've been putting together over the last few years, and just leave it open so that any member of the group can come by and pick it up and play it or walk around with it. I don't put any restrictions on it. The equipment's mine to donate, so I'm not having to answer to anybody for it. And I find that is extremely important to morale, for people to be able to express themselves in a variety of ways. We had a poetry group come in yesterday and meet with the musicians. I was very interested to see if the wordsmiths and the musicians could get together and maybe create some, put some of the ideas that we've been working on together and put them into music, somehow expressing what it is that we're all going through currently. It's nice to have music, songs that you already know, like from various other time periods, but I'd like to see what we're going through now put into music.
Now, you're from Ohio, correct?
I was born in New Jersey, and I was raised in Ohio. And after I graduated college, I came to Pittsburgh, and I've been here ever since. So I've been here since 89.
Okay.
And I have a family house in Ohio. I don't own any property in Pittsburgh, but I do travel back and forth to take care of the property. My mother's currently living there. And so I own that, and I don't own anything in Pennsylvania. So I have registered in Ohio, but I've been living here for 22 years, and this is my home.
So what made you join the Occupy movement? And basically, at what point along the line did you decide, that this is what you wanted to be part of, instead of, say, go to New York or go to Washington? Or
I was following the New York, the Occupy Wall Street movement online, and was very interested in what it was that they were trying to do. And I found out that they were organizing the Pittsburgh movement, the Occupy Pittsburgh, and a couple of my friends from the 22 years I've lived in Pittsburgh were on one of the committees to design their opening of the movement, the march and all that. And I had a little break from work because the materials weren't ready for me to continue process there, so I figured I would come and take some photographs of the march and you know, since I knew some people, I was like, okay, well, I'll come in and I'll video and photograph and, do that. I never had any plan to really become as wrapped up in it as I am. And it was sort of a moment-to-moment, day-to-day kind of decision. I didn't decide that I'm staying right away. I was sort of like, oh, I'm still here. I went on the march, and then I set up a tent. I hadn't pre-planned that. Then, one thing after another, and I'm just working with what comes at me from one moment to the next, never really having decided to stay or what. But as things go, I've totally fallen in love with this group of people, and I care a great deal for them. Try to keep everything safe, and whatever skills I have available to me, I utilize for that reason. Aside from all of the reasons the group itself has come together, I also see the group as a body of individuals that need to have someone care for them and look after them as well. And that kind of holds us together as a team a little bit. If we can find comfort in standing together, then we can accomplish what it is that we set out to do.
Well, thank you, Tom. I do appreciate your time, getting your story out to everybody. Any last words to the other Occupy movements, anybody, anything to anybody in the rest of the world you want to say? In closing,
stay strong, brothers and sisters. Absolutely. Stay strong.